Christians believe that animals were created by God for humans to use and care for. Many believe God values animals, but that humans are more important because they were created in the image of God and have souls. The story of Noah's Ark and the flood shows this. God commanded Noah to take animals into the ark so they would be safe. In Genesis chapter 7 verses 2 to 3, God says, "Take with you seven of every kind of clean animal, a male and its mate, and one pair of every kind of unclean animal, a male and its mate, and also seven pairs of every kind of bird, male and female, to keep their various kinds alive throughout the earth." This shows God's desire for humans to take care of animals. The Bible teaches that animals are to be treated kindly. Deuteronomy chapter 25 verse 4 says, "Do not muzzle an ox while it's treading out the grain." This command shows God's heart for his creatures. The idea is that the ox deserves to partake in some of his own labour, and so the ox must be allowed to eat while he works. It seems cruel to make an animal work for man to produce food whilst depriving it of the same thing. The animals that are laboured should be protected. Likewise, in Proverbs chapter 12 verse 10, it says, "The righteous care for the needs of their animals." This highlights the biblical principle of stewardship. According to this principle, humans should utilise and manage all the resources God provides for the glory of God and the betterment of his creation. This raises the question about whether Christians should eat meat. According to Romans chapter 14 verses 2 to 3, "The one who eats everything must not treat with contempt the one who does not, and the one who does not eat everything must not judge the one who does, for God has accepted them." It's therefore acceptable to be both a meat eater or a vegetarian as long as one doesn't judge the other in a negative way. After the flood, Noah was given permission to eat meat. In Genesis chapter 9 verse 3, it says, "Everything that lives and moves about will be food for you." Being vegan or vegetarian is a choice, but it's not compulsory for Christians. Christians should be sensitive to the beliefs of others about what they want to eat. People choose to eat meat because they believe it's a good source of protein and because the Bible does not teach that it is wrong. Some people, however, choose not to eat meat because they believe that animals shouldn't be harmed and that we can live healthy lives on vegetarian or vegan diets. The difference between a vegetarian and a vegan diet is that vegans don't eat any dairy products, so they don't eat any milk, cheese, eggs, or chocolate, in addition to not eating meat. When it comes to animal experimentation, scientists test products such as medicines, cosmetics, and additives that are used in processed foods on animals to check whether they are safe for humans. Normally, if it's safe to use with chimpanzees, dogs, or rabbits, it's likely to be safe for humans. However, this isn't always the case, as humans and animals are biologically different. In 1998, the UK banned testing cosmetics on animals. Christians generally support limited animal testing in order to develop medicines, and as long as it's carried out as thoughtfully and gently as possible. Christians believe that all human life should be treated with respect, so using animals to develop medication that may benefit millions of people and save lives is acceptable. However, in contrast to this, some people would argue that all living creatures have souls and all living creatures deserve protection. The idea that humans are stewards and consequently caretakers of the world means that we should care for all of the living things that God has created.